today what we are going to see. So we assigned this work to many of our internship program. Nearly 35 members are working in that. So there is no common procedure to them. They are taking more time to complete this work. So I thought I would like to frame some common procedure, standard procedure to complete this work on time. So that is the reason I framed this video. So you people can see here, after opening our topographic sheet, that should be properly clipped. So exact boundary only we required. I'm keeping that boundary of 58M12 topographic sheet. So if I open another sheet, so we will not find any difficulties while digitizing. If you like to capture some feature, so which is going beyond this limit, we can capture. So like that, we can clip that boundary. In this sheet, we could split into small grids. You see, total area, we may be our nearly 750 square kilometer. So we could split that into nearly 20 square kilometer like that. So each grid 20 square kilometer. Here you can see the length of the grid, the small grid. So nearly 4.5 kilometer. So 4.5 bar 4.5. So if we calculate this, 4.5 kilometer bar 4.5, so around 20.25 square kilometer area small grid. We are going to create this small grid. We are going to work on this. How? So we create some grids by using this grid tool. We require some rectangle. We can fix as the layer is our 12, and horizontal spacing we may be our 0.04166 degrees. Again we can paste here, then we can create grid file for we can save in desktop. So the folder we can create 58M12, so data for video lecturing, like that we can create. In that we can save grids 20 square kilometer, like that you can save it. So just you run it, system is created some grids. You can drag on top of this topographic sheet. Just you double click, we know the settings. So no brush, some thickness also we can increase as much as required, 1.5, like that. Now you can see each grid that nearly so many grids created according to our requirement. So unnecessary grid we can delete. So you go to edit mode, you delete this unnecessary grids. Now 31 grids are there. You can save it, that's all. Now you can zoom any one particular grid. Now we are going to create point data initially. Create new shape file, you know this and all. So the new shape file is it may be villages or habitat villages, whatever you can save. We have to type the name of the habitat village, add it, and it is point data. We know the same projection of the topographic sheet we have to follow. I saved. Now I am going to add each and every villages. So I am taking point tool, first village, and second village, third village, fourth village, fifth village. What are the things present inside of the grid only I am to capture? Sluice gate, that, and this is village. Here one more village, another village, another village, here another village, this one another village, like that. These are the village I captured. Now I would like to capture wherever this house locations. I create another layer, create new shape file, that is house locations. You save it. That is also point data. You don't want to give any name, so just if required you give name. That's it. Just you give point data. Now you go to edit mode. You capture wherever individual houses are there. You capture that as a point data. If required, you can zoom it. Wherever required, you can zoom it. Like that. So these are all group of buildings, so we can capture that as a polygon. This also group of building, so some individual houses far away from the group of building, that we can capture. Like that. Here also group of buildings are there, so wherever required we can capture as group of building. If separate individual houses may be there, so that we can capture by this manner. So the buildings which is present, that pink color, that settlement area, you capture as polygon. Some buildings far away from the settlement area, so that we can capture as point. So now we capture most of the point features, so within the grid I think we captured. Here 1 or 2 is there, but also if required we can capture. All other features are in group of buildings, not individuals. Okay, so like that we can capture this entire grid. Don't go beyond that limit. Now we can capture the settlement area. Now you can save edit this village also, save it. Later we can give the name of the village. So again you can create new shape file, that is settlements, settlements, save it. So that is polygon. You give name of the settlement and add, give OK. So the polygon layer is there. You go to edit mode. Again you capture this as a individual polygon. wherever pink colors are there, you can capture. So we will not able to skip any of the area. Just you capture as polygon. So you leave that wherever that individual points already we captured. Now you can capture group of buildings like that. Again, so here also some buildings are there. If you are comfortable with this, you can try. Otherwise, if you want a rectangle tool, that also we can use it. So like that. Like that you can capture all the settlement area. So only you focus inside of the this grid. Don't go beyond the limit. Wherever possible, just you capture. You see how beautifully looking like. Or you can add some rectangle tools, we can use it. Which is available in QGIS, that is edit geometry, add rectangle from extent. This tool you can use to get beautiful rectangle. It is also can simplify our work. It can create only horizontal rectangles. So then we can take some other tool, rectangle with 3 points. You draw a segment, then you can drag like that. Draw a segment. You can drag like that. Draw a segment. You can move. Here you can draw a segment. You can move like that. So you can capture. It is beyond the limit. So you can move here. like that you can capture all the that settlement area. Beautifully you could capture. You see. Wherever required, you capture this as a square or rectangle. Wherever group of buildings are there, our Survey of India, they did like this. Sometimes circle is there as well as regular polygon. So add regular polygon from two points and corner like that. That also you can try. So this is hexagonal if required. And center. Regular points from corner. So it is also coming different manner. So most of the cases we capture as a rectangle from three points or like that. You capture three point. We capture three point. So the fourth point maybe system is assigned. So now you captured wherever settlements are there, we captured. So this kind of case we can use ordinary our polygon tool to close this settlement area. Now we capture all the settlement. Now we can move our road network. Now you save this, then you can create new shape file, that is roads. Then you can, that is line feature, you can give road name NH or something, state highways. For that reason you have to give name also. Then you can start digitizing. Before that we need to give some snapping option. Roads, you should snap vertex as well as segment. We can give 5 pixel like that we can give. And settlement also should not overlap, that setting also should give. Other things no need, just you allow, you follow that advanced configuration. Self intersecting like this if you give, close it. Now we are going to start road network. So you start outside. So your zoom level should be less than 5000, then only we can capture road network. If you see any junction, you stop there. Again you start it should avoid some dangle errors. Like that, you see. Wherever curves are there, we should give more points. So we are crossing culvert. Road should not stop. Trees on the network. We should capture center line of the road. You see. Should capture center line of the road. Wherever possible, you can capture. After reaching the destination, just stop it. It's not visible. We can change the color and the thickness of the road. Like that in black color, we could increase the thickness for our understanding. We capture this. So like that, you also can capture this road, another road. Like that, you stop. Here also, the road is moving from this location. So you stop here, this junction. Again, you start, and from this junction, you go down. So you can off this layer. Wherever road you are not able to see, just you capture you give more points on this curve. Some snapping issues with the building, that is settlement area, that is the reason it is not permitting to move in curve manner. You go this way. If there is no curve, you can move. You stop here. If you find any junction, you stop there. Again, you can digitize like that. So maximum zoom level, if you do that work. So while seeing that minimum zoom level, it may be very accurate. Like that, you can capture. If you go this way and stop working. Here we capture another road that is moving like that. Maybe under construction or some other thing, they put some different color. You stop here. Okay, so after that, this is single path, but there is no junction here. We blindly we moved there. And snap. Later on we can check and correct that kind of errors. Here also, it is moving. It may be footpath. it may be before 25 years, it may be footpath. Now they may be paved any kind of road, I hope. So here also it is joining like that. Here some path may be there. You see, it is moving towards this direction. This is a junction. You connect these. Like this, we can capture road network. If anything we missed, no, we didn't miss. But here one footpath is there, we have to capture. We should not leave the footpath. It is a permanent route. People may be moving from one location to another location. So now we capture settlement, road, as well as now we are going to capture canal or streamlines. So we create a new shape file that is streams. You save it. That is also line string. Name first order, second order stream, like that you can write later on. Just you give line name. So there is a water body. How the water can come from higher location to lower location? Maybe use some streamlines. So here also another streamline which is moving towards this pond. After that, from that pond also there is a way it is moving. Here also some other route. It may be man-made canal. Like that. If you find, if you see any blue color, it may be perennial canal. If it is black color, can change the color according to our record. Like that. See, you can start from some little bit outer of this grid. Like that, you can capture. You should not stop even road, railway track. Please moving. We will not able to stop this water until reaching the ocean. Like that, we can capture. It is moving inside. After this, some other way. Is going here. There is a split, you see, culvert. The water can go down side of the culvert and reaching this portion. So we didn't snap, you see, it is an issue. Again, you have to go for snapping option with the streamline. So vertex as well as segment. So you can use the vertex tool to snap. It should be in network. Here also it is moving. like that. Up to here you can stop. Then you can use that snapping option. Wherever straight lines are there, so you go straight. No need to give more vertex. Here also we could stop. So here we are not coming again. So we did some mistake. The water is not going inside. Now we can capture as a culvert. You see, from this culvert it is joining here and it is going a road this side also. There is a canal, two side canal between this road. Again it moves inside of the settlement area. Now you see how beautifully the canals are designed, and there is a culvert we can cross. Like that, we could capture. So this canal starts from other sheet. So either you can start. Like that, you can move. And you can join here. After that, you can go. So now you see this left somewhere. Like that. Here also some culverts are there. You see some bracket is appearing. Water can move towards this direction. Like that you can capture. Just you snapped and you start. Stop and start immediately. Then you can follow like that. Just stop it. Then these lines are here. Again, you can start here by snapping. There is a culvert we connected. So the branch of the canal, irrigation canal, you can capture like that. You can join here. Here you can see कैप्चर। लाइक दैट यू कैन कनेक्ट, सो सम मिसिंग कैनाल इज देयर। Like that, you can capture these streamlines. So one or two streamlines may be missed here. So it is connected from existing streamlines. You should not do our own assumptions. Either you can capture all the streamlines. So only one grid only we are doing, not all the grids at the same time. Then only how much area you completed, how much area of the sheet you completed if they ask. So one of the 36th portion I completed. If I complete 18, so half of the sheet I completed, like this we can tell. So it start somewhere, you see it start here and moves inside of this settlement area, then it goes to and connect to the existing stream. Like that you can capture. So every streamlines are now network. You can see every feature has been snapped properly. So this is a culvert, it is connected. So culvert means for water can go down. Like that you can capture all the streams. Now water body, we can capture water body. Create new shape file, water body. That is polygon name. And add new location. Let's give zoom in. Wherever water bodies are there, you can capture. If you find any temple, there may be some little water body or tank. Maybe there. You should think some logic. So many ponds and lakes are there, small small ponds for drinking purpose. That time they use only small pond nearby temple. Like that you can capture the entire area of the tank. Sometimes circular tank, sometimes rectangular tank. So it may be present temple. They kept, they used some pond. So if any villages are there, the pond may be as a default. For drinking purpose, there was another sources to capture up to this. So here also font. Like that you capture all the font. And so maximum, then only you could give more points. So you missed any water body, you can check it again. Okay, again, what we missed? We didn't miss anything. Now you can enable this, you can save the village name. Open attribute table, nearly 14 villages. You zoom the village, so village points we can give different approach for understanding clearly. Name of the village you can type in edit mode. Up all other layers other than village, it may hide. So next village, what we capture? Vera. So third one, Thunder Ma, so just resume it. CHETTI Thangal. After that, Keel, Kanda, Kadambo. Male, Kadambo. Gun Airy. Male Theru. Tora. Two times they mentioned that. Like that, you can name, you can display the name. of this image. You enable all the layers. Now properly we digitize the small grid of the topographic sheet. Okay, so it may be useful for you. Similarly, we have to follow this kind of procedure to digitize other grid, other 36 grids. Now you can see nearly 45 minutes I take. Okay, other people can take, so it may be according to the features. It may be 1 hour or it may be 30 minutes. Averagely, how many hours are required? 18 to 25 hours required to complete each of the topographic sheet. So this is the procedure. So what will happen if I want to check any topology error? That I show you in next video. Thank you very much.